So that was the clean. The next movement we're going to go over is the snatch. So talk about the snatch.
Okay, yeah. The snatch is the other lift in the Olympic lifting movements that we do. And the snatch is taking the bar from the ground all the way overhead in one movement. So there's no stopping the bar. It's moving all the way in one movement. It's kind of known as the most powerful movement out of all the lifts or any kind of movement that we do, just because there's so much speed involved, so much, you know, hip extension, moving that large load really long distance very, very quickly.
Cool, let's do it.
So starting out, we're gonna just do a little warm up with Claire, and this is gonna just take her through kind of different portions of the snatch just to kind of get her warm and her body moving correctly. So the first thing she's gonna do is a dip and shrug. She's gonna keep that chest vertical, and all she's gonna do is dip at her knees and shrug her shoulders up. She's gonna dip up and shrug, keeping her arms straight. Yep, she's gonna do that 3 times, good. This is the Bergener warm-up, named after Coach Mike Bergener. Next, we're gonna dip, shrug, elbows high and outside. She's gonna try to make this, yeah, very good. Keep that bar really close. Cue I like to use is like you're elbowing somebody taller than you behind you. Really try to get those elbows high and outside. Everything is crisp, everything is fast. Next she's gonna do a muscle snatch, meaning she's just gonna, that bar is gonna follow the same path right up her body, and now she's just gonna turn it over, get it right over her head. Good, yep. Staying quick dip, dip and go. There you go, good. 3 of those, then we're gonna get 3 overhead squats. So getting that bar overhead, starting to prep herself to get under the bar and be able to catch the bar in a deeper position, which is gonna allow her to be more successful at lifting heavier weights. Good, then she's gonna drop the bar on her back, and we're gonna go snatch balance here, okay? So the key in the snatch balance is I'm not trying to practice driving the bar up and then overhead squat it. I can dip slightly, but I'm just to get that bar a little bit weightless, but what I'm really trying to do is fall to the bottom of that overhead squat as quickly as I can, stick the landing, and then stand. Good. Really stay down there until you're steady. Once you're steady, you can stand. And it's all about falling fast, getting under the bar, not pressing that bar up. Not bad. Very good. So that's one of the warm-ups we do to get ready for the snatch. If we put one all together, you want to try one all together for us, Claire? You'll kind of see all of these positions. She's going to jump, shrug up to those ears. Those elbows are going to come high and outside. As the bar comes overhead, she's going to go all the way underneath. Not bad. Really working to be powerful in those hips and jump. Good, not bad. One last thing we'll say. We want her in that same hang position that we talked about in the clean if we're going from the hang. So I'm gonna try to get her down to the top of the knees. Notice her shoulders are behind the bar. I want them in front of the bar. So she needs to push her knees back. Keep going, there you go. Now keep that chest tall, look out on the horizon. Now big jump. Good, make sure we get that full hip extension at the top. One more, big jump, hip extension. There you go, good.
Okay, so one of the biggest critiques we hear about CrossFit is that people get injured all the time. What's that about?
Well, you know, there's injuries in anything you do, first of all. Not that that's, you know, that's not ever the goal to be injured, but, you know, whether it be running, sports, we put our kids in all sorts of sports, whether it be, everyone's been watching gymnastics since the Olympics, and it's probably the most, if not the most dangerous, one of the most dangerous sports, more dangerous than football or other things. And so we do take risks in some of the activities we do, and that goes back to the importance of getting a good coach and being smart as an athlete too. Some of that onus is on you. When it doesn't feel right, when you try to push too soon, or you don't listen to good advice or sound advice, or don't know how to pull back a little bit on that throttle, I guess you could say, you run the risk of injuring. Anything you do, any kind of movement, there's some risk there. But if you get a good coach, they know what they're doing. It's pretty easy to tell, I think, most times, when you work with somebody, if you think they got their head on straight and can help you move properly and do it in a safe way.
And doing the warm-ups and stretching and all that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Right? Warming up, stretching, going through the movements early on with very little to light load, mm-hmm. and, you know, so a coach that's able to come in and say, hey, no, you're done. take that weight off the bar, not again, you know, versus sometimes that can be hard to do. So.
All right, so we hope that was helpful for you guys to learn some of the different movements we do at CrossFit, see the progression of learning just the basic movement, adding a little bit of lightweight, and then seeing some of the guys do it with really heavy weights. And please leave comments. Let us know if you have any other questions about different movements, different terminology you've heard, and we will definitely try to make some more videos with the Journey TV and get those answered for you.
And also, we're giving away an awesome goodie bag to randomly to someone in the comments below.
So thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys later. Bye.
Take it easy.